Right, so in the previous sessions, we have seen fundamentals of plant-based drives. So under this, we have different types of plant-based drives and stresses in belt drives, and later on the determination of different parameters like length of the belt, cross-section of the belt, right? So on and so on. Now here, the next type of belt drive is a V belt drive, right? So the belt cross-section is a trapezoidal cross-section here. Earlier, in the case of flat belt drive, the cross-section is a flat belt drive. Sorry, the cross-section is a rectangular cross-section. Now, the cross-section is trapezoidal cross-section, right? So the belt is made up of a number of materials like a fabric, cord, rubber, and so on. Earlier in the flat belt drive, the belts are made up of fabrics alone, or vulcanic material alone, or rubber alone, like this. But here it is a composite material. The cords are molded into the rubber material, so that the strength of this V belt is somewhat higher compared to the strength of flat belt, right? So, but the cross section is somewhat complicated cross section compared to the previous flat belt cross section, which is rectangular, obvious. Now here it is. Look at the figure. So this is the cross section of a V belt, right? So these are the high strength material cords, right? And this is a rubber, and these cords and rubber bundled with a fabric, and the entire part is molded in a rubber part. This outer one is called a any problem? Right, so the V belt is generally used in the workshops or factories where we want to transmit more amount of power, right? And the distance between the shafts is also very less than we can go for the V belt drives, right? So when the distance between the shafts is almost 8 meters or 8 to 10 meters, we'll go for flat belt drive. But when the distance is very less, like it is less than 4 meters, you can go for V belt drive. So the V belt drives are generally used in trains, right? More than one V belt is used, right? The reason being, the failure of one V belt may not stop the working of the machine, right? So in order to get the continuous working of the machine or the mechanism, more than one V belt is used here to transmit the power, right? So this is the pulley, right, which is used for the transmission of power by using V belt drives. So this is called a V groove pulley, which are provided with a number of grooves. As I said, the V belts are placed in waves or more than one in number. Obviously, a number of grooves are required on the same pulley, right? So look at this. This is of V shape, unlike the flat surface on the pulley. So the included angle of this is generally denoted with 2 beta. This angle generally varies from 30 degrees to 40 degrees. The angle between these wedge surfaces of pulley is generally 430 to 40 degrees, right? And here the power transmission between the belt and the pulley, or between the shafts, takes place due to the wedging action between the belt and the pulley surface, the pulley wedge surfaces. Whereas in the case of flat belt drive, the power transmission takes place between due to the frictional grip between the bottom surface and bottom surface of the belt and the pulley surface. Whereas here, the wedge action between this slant edges of a belt and the wedge shapes of this pulley are the reason for the power transmission from one shaft to another shaft in the case of V-bell rise, right? So, as usual, like I have a flat belt, this is thickness of the belt, and B is the width of the belt, and 2 beta is the wedge angle or the included angle of the groove of the pulley, right? So, the V-welders are generally used for the high power transmission, right? And since due to the wedge action between this belt and the pulley surface, here there is no chance of slippage like in the case of flat belt rise. So that's why you will get almost a positive drive using this V-belt rise. That is the advantage of the V-belt rise, right? So, this is the basic fundamentals of V-belt drive. Now, we will see the advantages of V-belt over flat belt drives, right? So, as we have already discussed, the distance between the shafts is very less, then we can go for the V-belt drive. Obviously, this is a very compact drive compared with the flat belt drive, right? So, the wedging action between the belt and the pulley groove will not allow any slippage. That's why the positive drive is obtained by using this V-belt drive, right? During the power transmission, there is no power loss at all. So, particularly slip due to slip in the flat belt drive, right? And the third advantage is the V-belt is a smoother one. Right, V-belt gives a smooth power transmission. Right, you will not get any noise. Right, scoring noise is common in a flat belt drive. So you might have observed this in the floor mills or the rice mills. Right, some type of scoring noise is very common in the flat belt drive. Right, that may not be the case in the case of V-belt drive. So hence. You can say this as a smooth drive, right? So, since the cross-section is trapezoidal cross-section and we are using some stronger elements like parts, and the belt life is a little bit higher, definitely it will be higher when you compared with the flat belt, which is generally made up of fabric or leather, right? Or generally is made up of the single material, but a V-belt is a composite. V-belt is made up of a composite material, hence it is having a stronger life compared with the flat belt, right? So here the another advantage, the easy installation and removal, right? So you might have seen this V-belts in our slotting machine or the shaping machine, even in our drilling machine. So where you can easily remove the belt from the pulley, and if you want, you can engage the pulley very easily, right? So that means the installation is a bit easier compared with the flat belt drive, right? So as we have discussed in the third point, it gives a smoother drive, right? So because here there is no noise or the scoring, hence it gives a very smooth operation, smooth power transmission, right? Then ability to cushion shock when machines are started, right? So it can absorb the shocks, or it gives the cushion when you switch on the machine, right? When the shunt power is given to the shaft, there is a chance of some vibration in the system, that the vibration can be easily absorbed by the V-belts, right? So then this is generally used for the higher power transmission. Similarly, you can use this at a higher velocity ratio, right? The velocity of the belt, the belt speed is obviously higher compared with a flat belt drive, right? When the belt speed is more, the power transmission is more, and the velocity ratio is also more. So they can allow up to maximum velocity ratio of 10, right? So here, there is no limitation on the placing of tie side, right? Like in the case of flat belt drive, always the tie side must be at the bottom of the drive. But here there is no such type of limitation. The tie side can be considered either at the top or at the bottom. Okay, so these are the few advantages of V-belt over the flat belt drive. Okay, right? I hope it is clear. And the another advantage here, there must be some clearance between the belt and the pulley bottom surface, right? So it can allow it can avoid the contact of belt with the bottom surface, so that some amount of wear is reduced, right? So only you have the contact with the wedge surfaces. Okay, that's also another advantage, right? And when you look at the disadvantages of V-belt over flat belt drive, like advantages, right? The first limitation is it cannot be used with the larger center distance. Okay, so this is V-belt drive is generally preferred when the distance between the shafts is less than 4 meters, right? Even less than 2 to 3 meters. Okay, so when you want to transmit power between the shafts of larger distance, obviously this V-belt drive is no longer alternative. You need to go for flat belt drive. It is one of the limitation of this V-belt drive. So not so durable as flat belts, because here we are using rubber molding, right? The cards and the fabrics are molded in rubber, so rubber is not a durable material over a longer period, though the some strengthened elements are there in the belt cross section, hence the durability is a little bit less compared to the flat belts, right? The pulley construction is somewhat complicated, as you know. The trapezoidal cross section of the belt requires, right, the corresponding cross section, the grooves in the pulley. So the making of these grooves on the pulley surface, similarly more than one in number, a little bit cumbersome process and difficult process. And the pulley cross section is a little bit complicated compared to the pulley used in the flat belt drive, right? So actually, it is also subjected to creep, right? So though it is meant for the positive drive requirements compared with the flat belt, but due to this creeping, sometimes it may not be suitable for constant speed applications. Okay, so it may not give 100% positive drive requirements, but compared with the flat belt drive, it may give almost close to the positive drive requirements. Okay, so another disadvantage is the temperature changes may influence greatly the belt material. Okay, so the rubber is very much influenced by high temperatures, and so obviously the at higher temperature, there is a chance of melting of this rubber material, and there is a chance of jamming in the groove cross sections, right? So that is another disadvantage of this V-belt, right? So another thing is the centrifugal tension prevents the use of weld below 5 meters per second and above 5 meters per second, right? So we have already discussed, these are V-weld runs at higher speeds, right? So obviously the centrifugal tension will be higher, right? So this, due to this higher centrifugal tension, the speed is having a limitation between the V-weld speed must be in between 5 meters per second to 50 meters per second, right? So this is six are the main disadvantages of V-weld over the black weld. Okay, so these are the advantages and disadvantages of V-weld over the black weld. Main advantages, so the positive tire requirement is the main advantage, right? And another thing is the smooth and quiet operation of this V-weld is another advantage. Okay, and then obviously higher power transmission is another major advantage of V-weld for the flat weld. Okay, now similar to our ratio of driving tensions in our flat weld, also we have T1 by T2. What is the equation for the ratio of driving tensions in our flat weld? T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. Now, in terms of natural logarithm, 0.3 log T1 by T2 mu theta, that is ratio of driving tensions in a flat bed. So, here, external dome, you will get the cosecant beta. What is beta here? 2 beta is the included angle of the groove of the pulley, right? Beta is half of the pulley angle. Half of the included angle, right? So T1 by T2 is equal to E power mu theta cosecant theta. That is the modification in the ratio of driving tensions in V delta, right? So this is regarding V delta. Remaining everything, the calculations like belt length and other parameters like stresses, everything is similar to flat weld. Okay.